Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we are going to do a topic concept, that is your asset turnover ratio formula. This is a part of the ratio analysis chapter. Now at the end of the day, what we are supposed to learn over here is one bit, a portion or a slice of the ratio analysis, which is your asset turnover ratio formula. Which is basically, because it's a turnover ratio, the sales has to come up. It's the net sales, because you are considering the percentage of the total assets over here, because it's the assets ratio over here, assets turnover ratio. So net sales divided by the average total assets. Now let's understand this formula. Now what is this formula all about? See, your asset turnover ratio is basically your efficiency ratio that judges how efficiently a company uses its assets to generate, revenue. So here the asset ratio formula will go something like this. Your asset turnover ratio is equal to your net sales divided by your average total assets. So this is going to be your formula. Now the asset turnover ratio formula example. Now let's take a practical example of asset turnover ratio so as to get a more insight on this. Now there's a company that's called YMC company, which has a gross sales at standing at $75,000, and this is at the end of 2017 I'm talking about. Now the sales return, that is I'm talking about the SR, the sales return, with the help of which you will receive your net sales. So this is just your gross sales, as you can see above. Let's say your sales return is $5,000 and the total assets, let's say the total assets at the beginning of the year is, let's say, 1,20,000. Let's say this is 2016 or 2017 itself. Let's say the beginning of the 2017 year we consider is as a calendar year, and at the end of the total assets, let me just define this. This is total assets at beginning, expand this, and we'll say the next thing as the total asset at the end. So the total assets at the end is, let's say, $1,60,000. So based on this, we need to find the asset turnover ratio of a YMC company. First of all we need to calculate is the net sales. So I'll just write the answer part. What we need to find is the net sales first. So our net sales is going to be our gross sales less our sales return. So that's going to be our net sales. Remember, you need to deduct any sales return or discount, if any. Now we will calculate the average total assets by using the simple average method. Now the total assets at the beginning of the year, as you can see, is 1,20,000. The average of the total assets at the end is $1,60,000. So the average is going to be, we need to open the bracket, 1,20,000 plus 1,60,000. We need to divide this thing by 2. So we get an average of 1,40,000. So now we'll put the data into the formula, and it's quite simple. The asset turnover formula will go something like this, is equal to your net sales divided by your average total assets. So how about your net sales? Your net sales is 70,000 divided by your average total assets as 1,40,000. So if you just divide 70,000 divided by 1,40,000, you get 0.5. So 0.5 is basically your answer. If you compare the asset turnover ratio of, let's say, YMC company with the asset turnover ratio of similar companies under the same industry, we would be able to tell 0.5 is a really good number or exactly not. Now we'll need to understand the explanation part of the asset turnover ratio formula. See, the asset turnover ratio formula is completely, you can say, opposite of the asset to sales ratio. Remember this thing. In this ratio, we look at the net sales and the average total assets. So in the income statement, in the income statement, you will find your gross sales. You'll find what? Gross sales. And we'll get, based on this, the net sales after getting the data of the sales return. On the other hand, if you want to find the total assets, I'm talking about the total assets over here. If you want to find the total assets data, then for the same, we need to look at the assets that are at the beginning of the year, right? That's the first rule, the beginning of the year, and the assets that are at the end of the year. And then we can take the average of the assets at the beginning and at the end. Remember one thing, in the net sales case, we need to deduct anything that is related to sales discount, if any, in the due course. We also need to deduct sales return from this, from the gross sales, so as to receive your net sales. Now, if we want to go deep, we can use the, for this, in this particular case, we are using over here simple average. Now, if you want to go a little bit deeper in this, then we can absolutely go for the VAM method, which is also known as your weighted average method. Okay. Now, what exactly is the use over here? What is the use of the asset turnover ratio? See, unlike the asset to the sales ratio, in case of the asset turnover ratio, higher is good. Remember one thing. This ratio is better only if the ratio is higher. Now, why? This is a big question. Why exactly? See, if the asset turnover ratio, if it is more, it indicates that the assets of the company are, you can say, they have been properly utilized by the company, and that too, you can say, efficiently. And if this is less, then you can say the assets are not properly utilized and the assets are not being efficiently employed in the company. I'll give you an example. Like, for example, if you find that the asset turnover ratio of the company is, let's say, 0.6. So this means that the net sales are 60%, right, of the average of the total assets. Now, if your average total assets ratio is, let's say, 1, then the net sales are, can take as 100% of the average total assets. Now, when a company, let's say, buys a new machinery, let's say a company buys a new machinery, then the company can produce more products and sells out more products as well. As a result, the revenue of the company, you can say, the revenue of the company increases along the way. However, you know, if installing new machineries don't result to increase in the sales, that means either the machineries are, you can say, defective, either the machineries are defective or the company isn't able to, you can say, utilize the assets properly. Now this is your asset turnovers ratio calculator. You can check this out. At the end of the day, what you need to use this for is to make your own interpretation by, you know, punching few numbers here and there, by changing few datas, and you know, you will see amazing results out of the same. Let's say if you put your net sales as 1 million and your average total assets as 2 million, that means it's 0.5x. The more variable thing it is the net sales and not the average total assets. So let's change this to 2 million. So absolutely this will be at the increased price, that is a 10x. So as the net sales is going to increase, as the net sales increases, your ratio also increases. But as your net sales basically decreases, your ratio also decreases. We are assuming that the total assets is remaining the same because they have very little change, or if, even if they have, can be handled.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.